Hello and welcome to my Bustle blog, short Buzzblow. Join me on my journey through life and learn about the secrets of how to make stuff even if you don't know what you're doing. Today, how I built my first puppet. In the next 13 minutes of time-lapsed mind-confusing video, I will show you most of the steps it took me to create my first puppet. Go go! So, what is a puppet? A puppet basically is a doll hanging from strings that are attached to a wooden cross above. By manipulating the strings, I can move the doll and make it look alive. So I need two things. First, a doll with movable parts, and second, a cross to attach it to. The making of the doll consists of three phases. First, the skeleton has to be made with joints to make it flexible. Secondly, it has to be filled to give it a shape that looks human. And thirdly, I had to create some clothing for obvious reasons. As you can see, I'm already making the skeleton. I started by cutting the bones out of paper to get a rough idea of the proportions. The doll itself at the end is about 55 centimeters high. Then I went to the hardware store and bought some wood. Thin, round wood. About a millimeter in diameter. The plastic pipe that is used as a spine was a leftover from another project, so I was just lucky to have it. First, I cut the wood in the right length according to the paper skeleton. Then I cleaned everything up, labeled everything, and drilled holes in the spine to fit the shoulder part and the hips, and also lots of pilot holes for the eye screws. I decided to use eye screws on each end of the bones to create the joints. Another option was to glue some fabric in between, but that did not convince me. It was really tricky. To put two screws in each end of the bones and to fix them together seemed the easiest way. On top of the shoulder, I put another piece of wood in the spine part to attach another eye screw on it to attach the head on top of it. So it's also flexible and can look down and up and stuff like that. So now the skeleton is finished, and as you can see, we have the legs and the arms and everything, but what's missing is the hands and the feet. At the hardware store I also got a piece of squared wood, which I used for the cross above, you will see later. So I just took four pieces of it for the hands and the toes. And I just grinded them and grinded them to almost look like shoes. And also I put some pilot holes in it to attach another set of eye screws. And I also had to round up the hands a little bit. While doing this, I decided my puppet should have thumbs. So I took some of the round pieces of wood and cut them really small, attached them to the hand, and put some magnets inside to make the thumbs even able to pick up stuff. A really tricky part about the eye screws is that they are linked, so they are closed. So you have to take two pliers and twist them to open them, and then you'll need them again to close them to fix the joints together forever. For now and until the cloth was done, I left them open, so every time I put the skeleton up for storage, it was really tricky because it was falling apart all the time. So, I finally got my skeleton. So let's quickly clean up everything and start the second phase to give it a shape to make the doll actually look like a human, not like a creepy skeleton stuff. So as you can see, the skeleton is almost falling apart by itself. I started with a torso using some cotton wool, lots of cotton wool I had laying around, and some sticky tape to give it a shape. I had to use multiple layers to give it at least a human shape and to add more and more volumes on the critical parts of the body. Having done this, I decided that the upper legs had to gain some more volume as well, so I started covering them in cotton wool as well. Then I put the skeleton back together. For some reason, in this stage, the skeleton reminded me of a kind of skinned chicken that's just laying around there doing nothing, but it will be much better soon. So we switched scenes now. As you can see, we're on the sewing table. I decided that my puppet should have like a t-shirt. The t-shirt itself should be made of this silver fabric. So I put the puppet on the stretched out fabric and stitched the outer proportions in the fabric, because the charcoal didn't actually paint on this, because it was white chalk and white on silver. I had no chance to see the lines. So a t-shirt has two parts, the front part and the back part. So I had to cut it out twice. Therefore I just folded it over and stitched it together so it wouldn't move away when I was cutting it. And yeah, I just cut two pieces of fabric at once. Yay, great science. Just make sure to know where to cut, and I cut my first tiny t-shirt. After that, I had to prepare the sewing machine. And as always with the mechanical stuff, you have to repair it before you can use it. So I just fixed everything up and started sewing it together. At first I took the ends, like the sleeves and the bottom of the t-shirts, and folded them in and give them a quick sew so it doesn't look so crappy. And after that, I put both parts of the fabric top on top. So put them on the left, as you say. So I just put some needles in there to, again, prevent it from falling apart when I was sewing it. And we just run across the outer parts of the fabric. Easy as that. Doobie-doobie-doo, lots of fixing to do. When you're sewing, you have to be aware not to sew over the needles you use to put the fabric together. Otherwise you could damage your machine or your needles. But that's not a problem. Just clean up the left of yarn, however you call it. And we put it inside out now, which is outside out, like it's supposed to be. So a quick bug fixing here and there. There's the t-shirt, there's the torso, and we just put it in. It's a lot easier if you take off the arms and put it in the t-shirt, and then put the arms on in again. As you can see, it's working really fine. And now I closed the eye screws again, so the arms can't fall off again. So it's like the final stage. So I need some pants now. As you can see, for measurement, I put the legs back on, took the fabric I wanted to use there. This time I'm using the chalk and some measurement to get a rough idea of the proportions of the trousers. Put some needles inside so it won't fall off again, and just cut it out. So again, outside in, we just fold the top of the pants and the bottom of the pants in and give it a quick sewing, so it doesn't look so crappy. You can see it in the close-up at the end a lot better. Then we turn the pants back on left side, put some needles inside again, and just sword. One big U coming and the two outer sides. So when this is done, we have to put back on the right side and to put the pants on the puppet. Again, it's easiest to just take off the legs, and if the battery didn't die, you could have seen this. So that is the blurry result of my first 3 hours or 4 hours of hard work. Now all we need is a hat and a cross. What is made of wood and almost a puppet and is everywhere in Germany? That's right, a wooden nutcracker. As it comes, I had a really ugly nutcracker on my hand and I decided to salvage the hat and turn it into a puppet. So first thing I had to do is to cut the really big hat on top of the hat, and I just took the cone, but accidentally I cut it in two pieces. I cut the torso and then put some glue on it and fix it back together. Easy as that. You have your own puppet head. Ta-da! So next thing is to make the cross. Again, I used the good old eye measure to figure out where to cut. Just cut the square wood into pieces. So the idea was to put the head on the right hand side to hold the puppet. Then on the first T-crossing, it should be movable for easy walking-like motions. And on the ends on top, the hands were attached. As you can see, I'm wearing gloves now. That's because when I was preparing the nose of the puppet, I really cut myself. So I decided it's good to finally use some gloves. So I made a little learning here. So I took this bolt from my old IKEA set, which should go through the first T-crossing to make it movable. So I just cut the end of the bolt and drilled really big holes in the T-crossing, and I glued it in the handles. So last but not least, I had to fix the upper T on the handle, on the cross. So I decided to just screw it in there. So pilot hole in the upper T section. I carved a little section out to actually fit it better together. And just had to screw it. Easy as that. Little glue coming. Little paper to prevent it from gluing the wood together, so because the middle T should be movable again, and just let it dry for a few hours. So here you see the finished puppet, the legs, the body, the t-shirt, the painted head with the nose of pain and the eyes, which is connected to the back part, to the lower part of the crossing, then the movable first T-crossing and the fixed second T-crossing for the hands. My first puppet. So if you want to use the puppet on camera, you really should paint the yarn, the nylon yarn, black, so it doesn't reflect in the camera. But now, for demonstration reasons, it's best to leave it like that, so you can see where the threads are running. So that's it. Thank you a lot for watching, and see you next time.